So there's this story in the Bible, and it's of Jesus teaching in the temple courts. And he's teaching the people, and then all of a sudden, this group of Pharisees comes up to him. And these are the religious teachers of the law of this day. And they have with them this woman, and they say that they've caught this woman in the act of adultery. Now, they're religious teachers of the law. They know the law very well. And the law of Moses, they say, demands that we should punish this woman by death. Now, the penalty of adultery is death. And then they come up to Jesus and they say, "What do you say?" And I think that's a pretty important question. What would you do? Would you do what we would do, which is kill her, what the law demands? Would you stand against her, or would you do something else? What Jesus says is pretty amazing. First, he kneels down and he begins to draw this line in the sand, and no one really knows what that is or what that means. But then he says to them, those of you without sin, you can cast the first stone. So the Pharisees, they look around at each other, and one by one, they begin to leave because they realize that, you know, none of them is without sin. And then Jesus comes to the woman and realize, he said, those of you without sin, those of you without sin, you can cast the first stone. And if we believe what the Bible is to be true, then we know that Jesus is the only one there without sin. He's lived a perfect, flawless life. So really, he's the only one with the right to actually kill this woman. But he kneels down and he says, has anyone here condemned you? The woman who was caught in adultery, she looks around, probably terrified, and she sees no one. She says, no, no one has condemned me. And Jesus says, well, neither do I. We see countless instances in the Bible in which Jesus is for people. In that instance, he chose not to condemn this woman, not to look just at her sin, but to look past that and be for her as a person. We see this in the story of Zacchaeus. He comes and he eats with a sinful tax collector. We see when he's dying on the cross, the criminal on his side. He says, tonight we're going to see each other in paradise. On and on, Jesus is for the weak. He is for the defenseless. And that's kind of the story of Jesus. So if Jesus was for people, and if we're the church, and we're supposed to be the body of Christ, doesn't that mean we're supposed to be for just as well? But it seems like that's not really the route the church has taken, especially these days. I mean, you look around in society, and all you really see is the church standing against things. I mean, we stand against homosexuality. We stand against the Democrats, or sometimes the Republicans. You stand against, we even stand for certain lifestyles, people that don't seem to be like us. It's almost like we've drawn a line in the sand ourselves. And if you live this way, then you're on this side. But, you know, if you hang out with these people, or you talk this way, or you vote for this specific politician, then you've crossed the line and we're against you. Perhaps the reason that the church is seen as such an irrelevant thing to the younger generations is because all we've done is stand against things in our culture. It's not that we shouldn't have convictions, and it's not that we shouldn't stand up against sin. But when we look at the life of Jesus and who he hung out with, when we see that he was for people and he looked beyond their sin, what could we be for as a church? What if the church was known not for what it was against, but what it was for? For people, for the weak, for the defenseless, for the widow. What if the church loved and produced and created and supported? What if as a church we stood for people? What if we were for the homosexual, the greedy politician, those that can't seem to get their lives together, the alcoholic, and not for the sins that have corrupted them, but for the people and for the children of God that they are? Jesus was for us all the way to the cross, where he bled and died. What if we were for us?